This video introduces how to configure service level agreements, or SLAs, in the ServiceNow system. An SLA defines an amount of time for a task to be completed, like resolving an incident or fulfilling a service catalog order. While the SLA is running, it can perform actions at specified times, like sending notifications to remind an assignee about a task or informing a supervisor if the SLA has expired. You can define SLAs for lots of different tasks, like incidents, service catalog orders, problems, or changes. In this video, we're going to use the example of SLAs for managing incidents. To see the SLAs defined in the system, we'll go to the SLA Definitions page. Here we see three SLAs for resolving incidents, one for each incident priority level. Let's take a look at Priority 2. The Table field specifies which table the SLA applies to. You can choose from a variety of tables for different tasks. This SLA applies to the Incidents table. To define an SLA for change tasks, you'd choose Change Task, and so on. The Workflow field specifies a workflow for the SLA. Here we're using the default SLA workflow. Let's take a look. Here we can see that when 50% of the SLA duration has elapsed, the system notifies the assignee. At 75%, the system notifies the assignee again. And at 100%, when the SLA time has expired, the system notifies both the assignee and the assignee's manager. The Duration fields let you specify the duration of the SLA. The duration determines the timing of the events in the workflow. You can choose a preset duration or specify your own. Here, the duration is 1 day. The Schedule fields let you specify days and times when the SLA clock is ticking and when it's stopped. Here, the clock never stops. If you choose SLA Definition, you can choose from a list of defined schedules. You can define a new schedule at System Scheduler, Schedules, Schedules. If you choose Incident field, you can choose a schedule field in the incident record. Please remember, if you specify the duration in days here, each day is 24 hours, not one business day or one calendar day. The hours elapse according to the schedule you specify here. If we choose 8 to 5 on weekdays, this 1 day duration, which is actually 24 hours, lasts almost 3 full weekdays. For example, if an incident is opened at 10 a.m. on Thursday, the 1 day duration ends at 4 p.m. the following Monday. The Time Zone Source field specifies which time zone is used for the SLA schedule. Here we're using the caller's time zone. The Start Condition fields specify when the SLA starts. Here, whenever a record is added or updated such that the active field is true and the priority field is 2, an SLA is created for the record. If the record is updated later such that the start conditions are no longer true, the SLA is canceled. If the retroactive start field is clear, the start date and time for the SLA clock will be when the SLA was created. If the retroactive start field is selected, the start date and time for the SLA will be the value of the selected field in the task record. Here, the start time is when the incident was created. The Pause Condition fields specify when the SLA clock pauses. When the clock is paused, actual elapsed time does not count against the SLA time. Here, the SLA clock pauses whenever the incident state is on hold. The clock resumes when the incident state is no longer on hold. Alternatively, we could specify different conditions for the clock to resume. The Stop Condition fields specify when the SLA is completed. Here, the SLA is completed whenever the incident state is resolved. If the incident is resolved within the SLA time, the state of the SLA is set to Achieved. If the SLA expires before the incident is resolved, the state of the SLA is set to Breached. Finally, the Reset Condition fields specify when the SLA clock is reset to 0. The clock continues counting after it's reset. For example, we could reset the SLA when Approval is Rejected. This concludes our video. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.